Hey, it's Empress Virgo. I'm here with your pick a card reading. What energy surrounds me and my soulmate right now? Who is my soulmate? Is this a romantic soulmate connection? This reading will answer those questions. And while I'm speaking, think of which stone stands out to you. I have assigned a set of cards for each stone. So as I'm speaking, zoom in on which one stands out to you, or you can listen to the whole reading and see what resonates with you the most. I will have a part two of this video with different cards if you feel like this reading does not resonate with you. Again, this is a general reading. So as a reminder, a soulmate does not always have to be romantic. You can have more than one soulmate. It is not the same type of connection as a twin flame, but a soulmate connection can be a very impactful, empowering, positive influence in your life. Your soulmate can be a romantic relationship partner. It also could be a family member, a friend, anyone basically that you, I always view soulmates as you vibe on the same frequency. You have similar energy. You are connected to each other in a way beyond just your association, beyond just being in a relationship, beyond being friends. There's something that draws the two of you together. Even when time passes, you still feel the connection to your soulmate. Okay? And it's kind of always going to be there. Even if you're not in a relationship with them or you're not friends with them anymore or something of that nature, you know, I feel like one of my soulmates, it's, you know, we don't really talk or have any associations with each other at this point. But it's not a romantic soulmate situation. It's not romantic, but there's always going to be some type of energy that we both share and just, you know, similarities in regard to certain aspects of ourselves that have drawn us together in the past. And, you know, it's just something that is just always going to be there regardless of whether we talk or not. So that's just one example. Okay. All right. So hopefully while I was speaking, you had a chance to pick your stone. I'm going to move them over and do the first. So I already have an order set out. So this is going to be the first order. This is for the Jade Stone. All right. So the first card is, who has this person been to you so far? What type of situation have you encountered with this individual that is on your mind right now? Again, you have more than one soulmate. I'm talking about the energy right now. Page of Pentacles. This person has kind of always been a fixture in your life. For some of you, it could mean that, you know, this is someone you grew up with or someone that is, there's something anchoring you two together. But this person, you know, we see the Page of Pentacles, is very practical. They don't like drama. They don't like conflict. So this person hasn't really caused any issues to you personally because that's just not in their character. They just kind of been there for you maybe. They've been very steady, very reliable type of person. Now, next card is the energy that they carry. Libra energy. So this does not mean this person has to be a Libra, but there's some influences there. So this can mean just someone who's very intellectual. And also, like, because air signs are intellectual, but Libra is more the social intellectual. So this is a person who likes to relate to others through information, relate to others through shared interests, things of that nature. And this person, again, like I said before with the anchor card, this person is not like conflict. They're very harmonious. They like balance. They like peace. You know, they probably, you know, sometimes they might avoid certain situations, avoid certain conversations because they don't want to seem like the bad guy. Now, is this a romantic situation? Is this a romantic soulmate relationship? So opportunity shows me that there is a possibility that this is a romantic soulmate connection, potentially. This is not really a family member that, obviously, that is your soulmate, since this third card is related to romance. Is this a romantic soulmate partnership that you have? Is this the person that is, you know, your soulmate? Is there a potential for there to be a relationship? I see opportunity. Opportunity shows that there might have already been hints between you two that it's possible, but at the same time, there hasn't been any moves made. And referencing back to the Page of Pentacles that showed up, yes, this is not a very fiery situation between you and this person. It's more so a reliable relationship, a reliable friendship, whatever the case may be. And I'm going to pick another card. So I've already shuffled these cards. But the next card is going to elaborate a little bit more about your situation, about this opportunity that could potentially exist. So there's opportunity there between you two, but we have the Five of Wands. Now there's some conflict. One of you has a lot of, it's probably you more so than this other person. I feel like this other person doesn't like drama, doesn't like conflict. They kind of simplify their life, you know, by the Page of Pentacles and get this idea of this person. Again, like Pentacles is like Earth in astrology, right? Earth is about the results, what is logical, what makes sense, what is practical. It's not fiery, it's not emotional, you know, and it's not all about ideas. So, you know, that person, I feel like, is more, a little bit more relaxed or maybe laid back than you are. So this person that is potentially, you know, your soulmate might be seeing around you, there's some blocks there. You might have a lot going on in your life right now. Five of Wands, like, this conflict. You might have a lot of drama going on in your life right now, which makes it very hard for this potential person who maybe you haven't even been paying attention to. Page of Pentacles is, you know, is not a card that is very bold. It's not a card that is very noticeable. So it's very possible that this person could be, you know, someone who you can grow with or have a strong connection with, but you have too much going on, too much drama, too much other people. You have a lot of things outside of yourself that causes you conflict. You have a lot of things potentially outside of yourself, some things in your life that you need to get together, get, you know, situated before this opportunity with you and this person. And I have one last card for this set. Mercury in Taurus. So it's interesting that Taurus shows up because Taurus is an earth sign. And the person has played a role in your life as a Page of Pentacles. And Pentacles is relating to Earth. And so Mercury is dealing with the mind and thoughts and communication. All right. And so the opportunity with you two, it's more so that, you know, not a lot is probably going to change with you two in regard to your communication. You know, there is always going to be some type of communication between you two. Taurus is very steady and Taurus is very predictable. Taurus is a sign that is very, you know, predictable. They like the foundation that they lay for themselves. Taurus energy is very, you know, practical in the sense of knowing where they stand. Whether you agree with it or not, they know where they stand, they know what they want, and they know the foundation to their own life. And we have the Mercury here in Taurus. So it feels like for you and this person, in order for there to be opportunity, somebody might have to stop holding on so much to their fixed ideas. And so for you too, there is opportunity. Again, anytime there's any type of reading, there is free will. You are a free-willed individual. You are going to make decisions that you make. In everybody's life, there are things that happen in the way that they maybe are supposed to happen. But at the same time, we do have control over our own life and what we decide to do. And so this card right here is just rounding off this idea that in order for there to be opportunity, somebody in this relationship or situation is going to have to be a little bit more open-minded and flexible. Okay, and it could be them, or it could be you. I'm getting the sense that it might be them. It might be they don't view you as a romantic option right now because of the things going on in your life. And that once those things, you know, so it's on the part of both of you to try to work this out. You have to work through the external problems in your life, right? Just in general, you know, regardless of this other person. And this person might have to, you know, be a little less rigid in their thinking and their thought process in order for this opportunity to actually come to fruition as a relationship. But in general, you two have a connection. It's not, you know, it's not going to make or break your connection, I guess is what I'm trying to say with that. All right, so we have the next stone. Okay, if you pick this one, the set of cards is explaining your current soulmate situation. All right, this person, the role this person has played in your life, Queen of Cups. This person has been very caring toward you. Cups is relating to, like, feelings and things of that nature. You might need a lot more emotional connection than this person. This person may also just be someone who looks out for everybody. They might look out for everyone. Queen of Cups, when I see Queen of Cups, I think of not just only romantic relationships, but I think of like a mother figure or someone who, you know, wants to make sure everybody has what they need. They want to make sure everybody is good. They want to make sure that everyone, you know, feels, you know, a sense of source of happiness and positivity. So this person has been very positive to you thus far, the soulmate, you know, situation. I also feel like for some of you, it could be this is not a romantic relationship, but we'll see, because I'm going to pull another card. But Queen of Cups does not always mean romantic. All right, what's the energy of this person? Aquarius energy. So while this person has played a role of being very caring to you, in their personality, this person is very much a thinker. This person might come across as you know, very logical. And they're not overly emotional, but at the same time, they show they care for people in different ways. They have their own unique way, Aquarius energy in general, of showing that they care. And whether this is an Aquarius person, or this is just explaining this person's personality type or other influences, they care about humankind. So like I said before, the Queen of Cups card can mean someone who's very compassionate for all. You know, when I think of Queen of Cups, I can relate that to the Pisces. Pisces cares about everyone. Scorpio cares about, you know, when you think about water signs. Let me not go through that. But, you know, it's like how Cancer cares about family first. Scorpio can care about anyone, but Scorpio is very much intense with their partners. And Pisces cares about everyone. But Aquarius, so the Queen of Cups cares about everyone. The Aquarius cares about everyone too, but in a different way. It's not an emotional way. It's let me fix everyone's problems. Let me help humankind. Let me help the world. Let me change things up. Let me use logic. Let me use the Saturn energy. Because remember, Aquarius is ruled by Saturn and Uranus. Let me use the Saturn structure and goal-oriented energy with Uranus energy, the planet of, you know, being unpredictable and causing erratic change. Let me use that energy to produce something, to help others, to make something change or shift in a dramatic way. So this is the energy of that person, okay? Now, is this a romantic soulmate situation that you have right now? Unlikely. It's not likely this is a romantic soulmate relationship. This could be, like I said, it could be familial. It can be a friendship. Does not mean it's any less important. Some people, you know, everyone wants companionship, romantic partnership for the most part. But at the same time, some people find they have a lot deeper bonds with their friends than they do romantic partners. And, you know, if that's someone's path, that's what someone's chosen, that's fine. So it's unlikely this is a romantic situation. Let me give it another card to help explain this energy. Why? Well, two of wands. You're on two different plans. You're on two different paths. So the reason why it's not a romantic relationship could definitely be your soulmate is somebody who is in your life, someone who cares about you. This might be someone that you're a friendship or family member is more someone who is someone that you connect with. It's your soulmate at this time in life. Again, you could have more than one soulmate. Sometimes in life, you might be closer to one relative, right? While another part of your life, you might be closer to one of your friends. You know, everything happens in cycles and waves. Let me get one more card for you. Mercury in Aquarius. All right, y'all. So it's interesting because Aquarius shows up in this card as well as the last card for this particular set. And so Mercury in Aquarius, the mind, differences, you know, differences in how you think. You two might bond over that. This person might give you new ideas. They give you a different way and different perspective of looking at situations. This person might present solutions to you. This person gives you the nurture and caring that you want, but at the same time, they also stimulate your mind. This person doesn't want to see you fail, okay? So at this point in your life, your soulmate is someone that is not a romantic partner, but they're someone who is very caring towards you, but at the same time, they also challenge you mentally in order for you to grow and develop. Okay. All right, next, you pick this color, Reiki Stone. Okay. Knight of Wands. So far this person is very fiery. This person's fiery. This person is, shows up a lot in terms of they always want to help. I feel like for some of you, this person is very actions oriented. They might have done a lot for you. This person might be doing a lot for you. They might be, you know, whether it's helping you out financially or they're just doing things, you know, showing that they care, that they want to be with you. I think this is more of a romantic soulmate situation if you chose this card. Let's see what energy this person carries. So this set is showing Scorpio energy. Again, this does not mean this person is a Scorpio. It can simply relate to their personality types. It can relate to what's in their birth chart. It can relate to what houses their planets and signs are in. It can relate to that energy this person brings, okay? So Scorpio energy. This person might really be starting to like you. The way the Scorpio energy shows that they like you is not always being very ostentatious, but this person is very maybe curious about you. This person, you know, wants to know almost every intimate detail of your life, but at the same time, they might not be revealing a lot about themselves. And so, you know, what you'll notice a lot with Scorpio energy is there can be some kind of quiet intentionality behind how they flirt or how they show attraction to you. The way that they'll show attraction to you is kind of trying to be very intimate, wanting to understand more about you. More of a deeper sense of, you know, trying to find out this person is who they really want to be with. This person as well can sometimes come across as a little bit cold, like you're not sure how to read them. It's very difficult to get a read on this person, potentially, based on the Scorpio energy, all right? But I think it's positive that this person, the role they played in your life is very actions-oriented. You know, maybe they've done what they said they were going to do. Maybe they said, like, okay, let's go out. We're going to have fun. We're going to do this. And they actually, like, hold true to going out with you. They're not, you know, dodging. They're not changing plans on you. So I don't think this is the type of Scorpio who is being elusive. You know, this person is really trying to get to know you maybe in an in-depth way. Is this a romantic one? I'm going to say probably. Let me see which... with the advice cards. All right, so again, I'm using 5 decks. I shuffled all the decks. So just to get, you know, clarity, when you see any patterns in any of my readings, they are actually energy patterns because I have shuffled the decks thoroughly, put them, you know, together into sets based off the energy that, you know, of the situation for, you know, whatever people are going through. So we have a success card. Yes, it's a very positive indicator that this can be a romantic connection. This is a romantic soulmate situation. Now remember, that is positive. Same time, soulmate situation, just like twin flame, just like a karmic relationship, does not mean, there's no mandatory sentence for how long you're going to be with someone, is what I'm trying to say. You have twin flames who are not even together. You see what I'm saying? So I want to say that even though successful doesn't always mean like, hey, I'm going to be with this person forever, you still have to work as a couple to figure out what's going to be best for you. All right, let me get another card to give some energy. Just the energy reading on like, okay, so yes, it's romantic. What type of romance? Three of Swords. There's going to be some sorrow though. So yes, you know, nothing in life is always going to be easy in the first place. It does not mean this is destructive. Relationship, this does mean that it's not going to be really easy. Okay, you and your soulmate in this particular, you know, time in your life, somebody's dealing with some depression, some sorrow, some sadness. Someone might be dealing with issues from other people, whether that is ex-partners, whether that is family members. They're going through something that's causing them to feel a lot of stress or depression. All right, let me get another card to give you, round out your reading. Mars in Cancer. Okay. So, all right, lovebird. So, your soulmate connection is romantic. Okay, this is a person that you are involved in or that you know that it could become something deeper. But at the same time, there is some conflict I'm seeing. So, when I see Mars in Cancer is not a easy placement. If somebody has Mars in Cancer in their birth chart, there's conflict because Mars is the planet of aggression and, you know, action and dominance. And Cancer is about intuitiveness and being receptive, and it's about, you know, being very in tune with how you feel and caring about your family and things of that nature and security. So this is some advice for you. There is a need for you to figure out how you two can best deal with your issues. I'm getting somebody in this partnership has issues, and it's going to lead to some conflict if it's not resolved. You know, we see Mars in Cancer. It can become a very destructive relationship if whoever's feeling this hurt and intense, you know, sadness needs, you know, if they're not healing, if they're not seeking help, if they're not expressing, if they're not sharing with their partner, if you're not, you know, engaging in positive, you know, communication, you know, with each other, it can potentially be a problem. So this card, you know, this is showing like there's some work you'll have to do in your romantic situation. This is second to last. Get your anchor card. All right, King of Pentacles is your anchor card. So this is the role this person has played so far. King of Pentacles. This person is mature. They might be older than you. Maybe Pentacles, earthiness. Okay, this person is more established financially maybe. This person maybe has helped you out or you admire this person for what they've earned or what they've achieved so far. Okay? They might want to help you out. They might have advice for you. They might be kind of fatherly in some way. Okay? All right? Let's get their energy. Leo energy. Okay. So this person can have a very dynamic personality, you know, or they can just be very creative. But when I think of Leo energy, you know, especially if you're asking, thinking about soulmate, this person wants you to be happy. They want you to be satisfied. They might seek attention. This person might demand a lot of, you know, validation, but they want you to be good too. This person might have been generous to you so far. They might have been really, you know, they might make you feel that they really care, that they are proud of you. This person might be very social. They might be inviting you to a lot of things. This person cares a lot about how they are viewed by other people. This person cares about how you perceive them. They might ask you questions which show that they care how you perceive them, okay? Is this a potential romantic soulmate? Yes. If this is resonating with you, this person is a potential romantic soulmate. This is not a familial or family member type of soulmate connection. This is more of a, you know, relationship type situation based on the current energy right now. Let's get another card to get some clarity around that. Ace of Cups. I think this is new for some of you. This is new for some of you, or some of you might be on the way to a new step in your relationship or your, you know, your advancement with this person. The reason I say that is because, like I just said for the other set, I'm using 5 decks. I shuffled each deck thoroughly. So I pulled the first card for each set. Then I got the second deck, shuffled, pulled the next card. So all the things that you see that are patterns is picking up on the energy. All the cards are picking up on the energy. I'm picking up on the energy, and that's why I'm able to give this reading. Because right now I'm seeing this is positive. Leo is very expressive in love. You know, when a Leo loves someone, it's going to be very clear if they love this person. They want the whole world to know. In fact, it says yes. And Ace of Cups is a card related to love. But aces are the beginning. So for some of you, it's a new relationship, or it's going to be a new step in the relationship. Last card for your reading is Jupiter in Scorpio. Okay, now Jupiter in Scorpio is very interesting because Jupiter is about what's seen. Jupiter is about light. Scorpio energy is not about light. Scorpio energy is about the unseen, the hidden. It's about, you know, thoughts that are not, that are thoughts that are beneath the surface, right? And so in your relationship, there might still be some things you need to work out. So this person is someone that you are energetically vibing on the same frequency. This is a deeper connection, probably than past relationships, you know, things of that nature. But at the same time, it's like there's competing energies going on with between you two. It could mean that, you know, there's a lot of differences in your personality type. Okay. And so the Jupiter and Scorpio card is giving off the idea that there is still some incompatibility that you have to work through in order for your relationship to work. Because there, you know, you see Jupiter and Scorpio, it's not the easiest placement. Now, you know, it can be combining risk taking but being smart. So Jupiter is about risk taking, but it's about fortune. It's about getting, you know, what it is that you wish to acquire. Jupiter energy is about optimism, but it also can be very, you know, impulsive. But at the same time, we have Scorpio. Scorpio is not impulsive. Scorpio thinks, and Scorpio, you know, plots and thinks of the best way to have an advantage. So for your relationship, the way that I'm reading all of this together is saying, like, there are some differences between your two personalities or your lifestyles that you need to work through, but it's not impossible if you two actually value each other. It's not impossible. All right, guys, so here's the last one. Okay, last one. Queen of Swords. Queen of Swords. This person might be, you know, someone who gives you advice a lot, someone who's very logical, someone who is able to give you a lot of support, more so mentally. You might communicate a lot with this person. There might not be a lot of physical contact. This is someone you trust their authority, you trust their opinion, you trust them to kind of give you some sense of guidance. The energy of this person is Pisces. So the role they played in your life is giving you a lot of information, maybe helping you, guiding you in some type of way. We see Pisces energy here. What we're seeing with Pisces energy, this person is compassionate in their life. They could be someone who's very creative. This is someone also who they can sometimes lack what you view as structure. Pisces energy doesn't care about structure. It's mutable water. Pisces cares about what is going to make them feel good about themselves and what can help others. I don't mean that they're selfish when I said makes them feel good about themselves. Pisces is a very internal sign. That's why a lot of Pisces energy people are very creative, or people that have a lot of 12th house energy are very creative, or they spend so much time alone, they get really good at something. This is a person who's really good at something. This is a person who's very creative. This is a person who's very poetic, or this is a person who thinks outside the box. Pisces energy is very like open in that way. And so this person, you know, you could be attracted to that, but this is not necessarily someone who is, they could be unsure a little bit about some things. And so you could be questioning a lot, where does this person actually stand? They have all this compassion, or they're a very sweet person, but sometimes that energy cannot be as bold or as demanding, but you know, Pisces energy isn't going to be like Aries energy, where if they like you, they're going to be like, I like you, I kind of want you. Like, you know, it's going to be a different type of, you know, dynamic going on. Is this a romantic situation? Not the right time. This card is not saying no. This card is not saying no, it's a family member. No, your soulmate is actually a friend that you have. It's basically saying that right now someone is not ready. It's either you or the other person. For this type of reading, I'm getting a lot of energy that I believe for many of you, if you pick this one, this is more so this person is not ready. For my first set in this video, the first cards, I said the energy I was picking up was that you were not ready, that you had issues in your life that you had to solve if you were going to pursue a situation with this person. This reading, I'm getting that this other person is not ready. The next card is the energy card, just to help explain this not right time. Six of Wands. It's possible, though. It is definitely possible, because Six of Wands means victory. After going through so many different actions, there is going to be a lot that you two have to do, or that this person has to do. So it's not a mental block on this person's behalf. It's not really financial. It's that there are certain actions this person needs to take in their life. There are certain things this person has to overcome in their life. And in order to do that, you know, you can't really help them in that way. They have to do it on their own. But once victory is there, it's more possible that you could be in a romantic situation. This person that is your soulmate, it's possible, but this is not the right time. And a card to end this reading is Moon in Cancer friendship. So Moon in Cancer is the most intuitive, and it's very receptive. Moon in Cancer is almost, you know, not almost, they are very, you know, psychic. And so, you know, there is this closeness between you and this person. The friendship should not end. Even if you do not end up in a relationship, your friendship should not end. Your friendship will continue to be where it is. You two are not necessarily in a romantic situation right now, but your friendship will probably still stay until it is the right time for you and this person to consider being in an actual romantic relationship. Okay? All right. If you like this video, hit the like button. Also, there will be a part two to this video. So if this did not resonate with you, go to part two to see if that set resonates with you more. Thank you for watching.